Come on over the board with me. All right. I have two word problems I want to do with you. One of them is very simple, and the other one's just a little bit harder. They both deal with ratios like our math maze does. So the first question is, the water level in an ocean bay changes at an average rate of 3 meters per hour. At this rate, how many hours would it take for the water level to change 12 meters? All right, so the first thing you want to do is you want to sort of figure out what you need and what you know. So we're going to go in here and we're going to underline. We know 3 meters per hour. Now, I always tell my students to circle, or if they have a highlighter, highlight what you're trying to find. And it says, how many, so I'm going to circle how many hours to change 12 meters. You don't have to underline the whole or highlight the whole question. You only have to do little pieces of it, just enough to make sure when you get your answer, you're actually answering the question. Okay, so let's take a look. I like to set things up as fractions or ratios. So it says three, it's gonna fill in average rate of 3 meters per hour. So first thing I always have my students do is write a base ratio. So we're gonna do the meters on the top and then underneath the hours. Because this way, if they get pulled away, let's say you're at home, you're working on your homework, and all of a sudden your little brother wants you to come do something with him, well, you can go do it because when you come back, you have your base ratio set and ready to go. So now all we have to do is 3 meters per hour. So I have 3 per 1. That helped me set up that one ratio. Now, I want to know how many hours would it take for the water level to change 12 meters. So now I shouldn't have any question about where the 12 goes because it's labeled with meters. My base ratio says to put the meters on the top. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to put the 12 on the top. And this one, X, is what we're trying to find. All right. Now there's two different ways you could solve this. You could, because this is an easier one, you could just look at it and say, oh, what do I multiply 3 by to get 12? And then you can do the same to the bottom. Or you can cross multiply. Well, this one I'm going to do the easier method, and the next one I'm going to show you the cross multiply. So maybe it'll help you with the math maze. So I know to get to 12, I'm going to times this by 4, and that gives me the 12. But remember, when we're talking about fractions and ratios, what you do to the top, you also have to do to the bottom. So we're going to do the same down here. So I now have to do 1 times 4 to get x. So I know that x is equal to 1 times 4, which is the same as 4. But don't forget to label. Is it 4 meters or 4 hours? Well, you got to look at where the x is located. It's located in the denominator or in the bottom. So what did I say in my base ratio over here? I said the bottom was hours. So it's going to be 4 hours to get to 12 meters. All right, so that's one way you could do tonight's math maze. Now another one is if you look at this problem, we're not going to do it. We're going to try the cross multiplying because maybe that will help. It says a leaky faucet is losing water and is filling a gallon bucket every 20 hours. That's pretty leaky. At that rate, how many gallons of water will the faucet leak in 48 hours? So again, make your base ratio. So we want gallons. I'm just going to put a G, and then we're going to put it over hours. So now let's go in here and figure out what do we know, what do we need to find. It says leaky faucet losing water filling 5 gallons. So here's my 5 gallons. Oh, let me underline that. Let's keep the same idea. We'll underline what we know, 5 gallon every 20 hours. Now you circle what you gotta find. We wanna know how many, and I leave my circle open, you don't have to, how many gallons in 48 hours, okay? So now I've got my base ratio set up, and now we just have to set up our equation. So we're going to say we know 5 gallons every 20. So 5, because I put the gallons on the top and the hours on the bottom. So 5 and 20. And then we want to know how many gallons, so we know that our G, our gallons, our variables on top in 48 hours. All right, so another way you could do this is to actually cross multiply. So we're going to multiply this way, and we're going to multiply this way. Now, my students like to have their variables on the left-hand side. I don't know why. It just makes it easier, I think, for them. So we're going to do the same for them. So 20 times G, we're just going to rewrite it as 20G. And now I've got 48 times 5. Well, let's do that over here. 48 times 5. 5 times 8 is 40. Carry the 4. 5 times 4 is 20. Add the 4 is 24. So now I'm going to put 240 on the other side. Now you have a one-step equation, and what you need to do is find what 1G is, not 20 of them. So we're going to divide by that 20. Because 20 divided by 20 gives me one whole. Remember, what you do on one side of an equation, you have to do to the other. So we're going to do it over here as well. So we know G is alone here, and now we're just going to do long division. How many 20s are in 24? 1. Take away the 20. Bring down the 4 and the 0. Give myself a little bit more space. How many 20s are in 40? 2. 40. 0. So I know I'm going to lose 12 gallons, and notice I used a G this time, because that G reminds me that it's for gallons, not hours. So 12 gallons in 48 hours. Now, just one little clue on that math maze. You're going to do all this work, but that's not the end of it. Remember, they want to know how much the two of them have together. Okay, I hope that helps.